Good evening, everyone. The pleasure is mine to welcome you to our spring choral concert. We're so happy that so many of you could be here to support our young people. This evening, I ask you to please stand with me as we pray to begin. I'd like to ask God to be with all of our scholars this evening as they perform, so that they will perform with boldness, they will perform with confidence, and the Lord will bless them as they display their talents to his name, honor, and glory. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the opportunity to be here. We thank you for Spencerville Adventist Academy, and we thank you for the teachers, the parents that support it, the family members, and most of all, the wonderful scholars who attend. As they're going to perform this evening and share their talents, we ask you to be with them. Please give them the confidence to perform their parts, calm their nerves, and bless them. In your name we pray, amen.
Veritas Domini. We'd like to thank Mrs. Lanning for and the Adventist Children's Chorus for such a wonderful performance. As you can see here today, there are some special microphones here. And unfortunately, these microphones are not here for the stream, but we are streaming it today for those of you who have family members that can't be here. You can send out that link. And we do appreciate those of you who are watching online. And thank you so much for joining our choral concert here at Spencerville Adventist University. Wow, we're already a university. So the microphones here are for a special recording that we're doing of this live performance. And we hope that we will be able to provide for you a CD recording of tonight's performance and a digital link on MediaZilla of the recorded stream concert with the new audio added onto the video. So we will be giving you some information about that in a little bit. So you may be on camera, so smile. This is our live recording. And also, this is serving as a potential audition for some future competitions for both of our choirs. So we want to be able to showcase our students outside of what we're doing here today. So we really appreciate your support of both of our choir programs. All right, if I can have basses.
Thank you so much in advance for all that you have done and will do as we collect an offering. Please bow your heads with me. Jesus, we pray that you will bless us tonight, and thank you so much for the gifts of talents of music in our lives. And we ask that you would bless us and help us with everything that we do, that we will always send it back to you in praise of you. Thank you again. In Jesus' name, amen.
Before we begin this next piece, this is a piece we really have enjoyed. It's a spiritual by the composer Stacy Gibb. We had the pleasure of working with Stacy Gibb at the National Choir Festival this year, which the Honors Chorus, wave your hands, right? So they were able to work with Stacy Gibb, the composer, on a brand new composition. But this composition was actually his very first composition that kind of made him a well-known name in the choral world. And I would like to just read to you a short verse here from the Bible. Hopefully I can pronounce these words right. It's found in Isaiah 62. And I'm going to read from the King James Version here. Isaiah 62. And in this chapter, Isaiah is talking about how God is promising his children Israel will no longer be in the place they are in. So let me read here for you. I lost it here. So thou shalt no more be termed forsaken. And this is verse 4, Isaiah 62, verse 4. Neither shall thy land any more be termed desolate, but thou shalt be called Hephzibah, and thy land Beulah. For the Lord delighteth in thee, and thy hand shall be married. So as we were studying this song, Mrs. Lanning came to me and she says, you know what, I looked up the word Beulah, and she shared with me a little bit about what she found. And the word Hephzibah in Hebrew means my delight in her. In other words, the bride, right? And Beulah means married. So in essence, God is saying, you're going to be married with me. Right now, it's a very sad time. You're struggling here in this world, but one day you will be married with me and you will enjoy this land. So, and of course, the Negro spirituals, it was incorporated, the same idea of Beulah, and this is Stacy Gibb's version of Beulah Land.
Thank you so much for your support. It really means a lot to this choir. And thank you to everybody and Mrs. Lanning and ACC. We really appreciate all the hard work you do because this is what feeders into my program. So that's awesome. We'd like to close out this last piece called Esto Les Digo, and it's found in Mark, where it says, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I will be also. So we'd like to part with you in our concert with this piece, Esto Les Digo. We would like to take a moment to present some awards for you today. And these are awards for students in the choral program who have exhibited excellence In the choral program, I offer awards for students that are freshman to senior, and it's called the Award of Excellence. And it's an award that these students are able to exhibit that they have gone above and beyond what the course requirements of my class require. So that would be getting an A in choir, having an A average in their assessments, and also attending all the concerts. So after having those three basic requirements, these students have earned 4 points from a list of categories, including, but not limited to, voice lessons, being a part of the school play, attending extra concerts, being a part of a praise team, being a part of their church choir, anything that contributes to the life of the choir that betters our life by what they do and contribute. So these are the students that I will call for this award of excellence. Nathan Chachwak. Caleb Salasad. Angela Kopik. Sophia Couteau. Zoe Jenkins. Kirsten Zinke. Daniela Cruz. Cheyenne Hyde. Eric and A. I'm sorry. It says Elise, but I'm so sorry. Elise and A. Oh, you know you do it to your children, right? Heather Hernandez. Eloise Tran. And this was an award for the strings, which was not done during the string time, and that's Alex Yapsching. Every year we award in choir the National Choir Award. The stipulations for the National Choir Award is that I can only award it to one student with outstanding merit. And this particular student has also received some of these awards in the past years. And if I could read it to you. In recognition of singular merit, ability, and achievement, of outstanding contributions to the success of the school vocal program, and an unusual degree of loyalty, cooperation, and high qualities of conduct by the general consent of the music faculty, school officials, and others, the National School Choral Award is hereby conferred upon Rachel Ingram Clay. It will forever be in our hallways, and her picture will be there for the remainder of this year, and as we continue, I think into next year, we include her picture in honor of her contribution to our choral program.
A couple of weeks ago, our children's choir performed at the Hershey, Pennsylvania Music Festival, and there were only, out of the thousands of kids there that performed, there were only two groups that placed superior, and we were second to superior first place. So we came in second at a superior rating, and so they will all get their pin. Thank you, kids. But surprisingly, in addition, that day, there was an award given for Outstanding Vocalist, Bethany Kraus. I would like to say thank you to all of you who participate in choir. It has been such a huge part of our program here at Spencerville, and I would just like to recognize those of you who have ever been in ACC. Would you please stand? Okay. And then I want to ask one more thing. How many of you were in the very first group 9 years ago? Heather, you weren't? 9 years ago, it was Kirsten, Richard, Rachel. Eloise, Caleb, Rachel, and Sasha. I love you kids. Oh, and Will, and Will. We have an award for somebody who is a product of this very choir and this choir and so much more. And this person was given the award for the most outstanding achievement this year in the drama, Kirsten Zinke.
We're almost done here. I would like to ask all of the students in the honors course that participated at the National Choral Festival to please stand. For your participation in this nationally recognized festival, you will be receiving a patch for your Letterman jackets. Parents, you gotta get them Letterman jackets now. And they will also receive a certificate from Music for All. I'll read it to you. Music for All National Festival, congratulations to, put your name in there, and has your name on there. Spencerville Adventist Academy Honors Course on your participation in the National Choir Festival, part of the 28th Annual Music for All National Festival presented by Yamaha, March 14th through 16th, 2019, Indianapolis, Indiana.
25 years ago, there was a memorial set up by the great-grandson of the prophet of our church, Arthur White. His daughter, and I believe, is that right, Mr. Zinke? I think Arthur was the great-grandson of Ellen G. White, yes. And his granddaughter went to our school. And so his great-grandmother was the prophet of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. And so he was sending his daughter there, and he wanted to establish an award or a fund that would award students of exceeding excellence in music. And so we have, for 25 years, continued a perpetual plaque to honor students for their outstanding ability in the music program. They didn't necessarily have to be in everything. Some of them tried to be in everything. Some of them are in everything. But this was a person who went beyond the call of duty, just, you know, joining groups. This person would go to even take voice lessons and do extracurriculars just beyond what was required. And so for the 25th year, we have an award that will go to none other than Kirsten Zinke.
I heard lots of applause, but I think we need to hear a really hearty, strong amen for all of this tonight. Amen. I have to say that I'm going to play a little bit here with a couple of the pieces before I have prayer. I came out of retirement, as some of you know. And I saw something in the song here that says, I've been in the storm, okay? Well, let me tell you something. When you come to an academy, you could be sometimes in a storm. But I want you to know, it's been a little bit of heaven. These guys are amazing. The teachers have been amazing. And I just couldn't tell you.
Yeah, great.
You couldn't ask for a better place. Terrific faculty and staff, and I've made tons of great friends here. And so I just want to congratulate each one of you. Tremendous school. There's lots of academics, lots of musical areas, drama. I was blown out of the water with all of those areas. And I just want to say thank you to all of you. You've been amazing. Thank you. So let's bow our heads and have a word of prayer together again. Heavenly Father, we just been fed here spiritually tonight. What a blessing. We thank you for each one that has participated. We thank you for the parents who have come out to support their young people and recognize the value of joining and sharing the voice and the message through the music that we've heard this evening. Thank you, Lord, for all of that. And now as we plan to go home, I'll take another piece from one of the songs. The angels will take you home. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen.